Hi friends, welcome to SGK English for a new video. Today, let us learn a poem by Harinath Chattopadhyaya, The Earthen Goblet. This Harinath Chattopadhyaya was born in 1898 up to 1990. He was the youngest brother of Sarojini Naidu. You might have heard of her. Symbol of Indian womanhood, the great poetess Sarojini Naidu. Many poems are there. You will study some of them in higher classes. Okay. And he was an MB from Vijayawada too. Okay. So let us come to the poem directly. The Earthen Goblet. See, what's a goblet? It's a drinking, it's a vessel. Used for drinking something hot or something that goblets are used. Made of, earthen, means mud, clay, okay? Clay vessel used for drinking and liquids, etc. Let us begin the poem. Oh, silent goblet, he is addressing the goblet. Oh, silent goblet. Red from head to heel, you are red from top to bottom. Head to heel, you are, oh, silent goblet. Yes, you are quite silent, oh, goblet, you are quite silent. How did you feel? How you felt? How do you feel? How did you feel when? When you were being twirled upon, yes, made to move round and round, twisted and made to move round and round, where? Upon the potter's wheel. Yes, there is a big wheel of the potter's wheel moving round and round, and the clay will be shaped, it will be moving and moving, and the pot or the, tumbler or the cup or whatever be, or mug or whatever be shaped according to the shape given by the potter, one who makes pots. Okay, how did you feel? What were your feelings? You see, how did you feel? When you were moving round and round and round, where? Upon the potter's wheel. Before the potter gave you to the world, before you were made a pot or a tumbler, or a cup, or a saucer, and before you were made into a clay pot, you were part of the earth, how did you feel? Yes, you were part and parcel of the earth of ours, Mother Earth. So you were taken from there and separated from the Mother Earth. As a child is being cut from the mother's, womb, okay? That is removed when a child is born. And separation is being made as a child is separated from his mother soon after when it is born. So how did you feel? The feeling of separation when you are separated from Mother Earth and made a pot or a vessel. Yes, once again, first answer. Oh, silent goblet, red from head to heel. How did you feel when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel before the potter gave you to the world? I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away. See, I felt a natural, impulse of the feeling. Caution means very purposeful, very strong. I felt a very strong impulse to break away from the great potter's hand. I really want to break away from the hand of the potter, to escape, to get myself freed from. Now I am a slave. See, under the slavery of the potter I am now. But I really wanted to escape from the potter's hand and get my freedom. You see, that burned so warm while he was being twirled. See, I moved round and round and round. I became so hot and warm. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow. Then I felt a vast feeling of sorrow. To be cast into my present form. To be made into my shaped mold into my present form. I felt so sad. See, feeling of sorrow because I am separated from my mother, Mother Earth. Yes. See, I felt very sad, very sorrowful when I am separated from my mother, Mother Earth, and made a different thing, quite different from what I was, what I had been. Yes, the words of the, earthen goblet. I felt conscious impulse in my clay. In my heart, I felt a very strong impulse to break away from, you see, from that portrait's wheel and escape from there and go back to my origin, my place of origin, Mother Earth. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. I felt very sorrowful, very sad to be made an earthen goblet or a pot or a tumbler or a cup or a mug or a bucket or whatever be. I felt very sorrowful, very sad. I wanted to be part of where I had been, a part of Mother Earth, the soil. Before that fatal hour, that critical hour, you see, that deadly hour, that saw me captive, me slave, that hour made me captive or slave. On the potter's wheel, I was made a slave. On the potter's wheel. On the wheel of potter, I was made a slave. I was working, I was wandering and moving and moving and moving like a slave, doing his slavish work and cast into his crimson goblet sleep. Yes, crimson is a deep red, is a little blue also, bluish red. Red actually, see, first line is, oh, silent goblet, red from head to heel. Yes, goblet sleep. Now I am in slumber, I am in sleep, silent completely. First line, oh, silent goblet. My life is gone. A dead creature I have become. Like a dead thing, dead body. You see, my life is gone. When I was part of this earth, I was a living organism. I felt like that. I was a living organism once upon a time when I was part of the Mother Earth. I am taken from there and I have become dead. And I am asleep, I am sleeping, I am silent, completely silent. Yes, crimson goblet sleep. I used to feel the fragrant friendship. See, fragrance having fragrance, sweet smell, fragrant friendship of a little flower. Yes, I really felt the warm, fragrant friendship of a flower. Whose root was in my bosom buried deep. Yes, there were many plants growing, you see, through my heart, bosom. Bosom is heart. See, many plants were growing. Some of them were flowering. And the sweet smell, fragrance, sweet smell. I could feel that, I could smell that, I could enjoy that. The sweet smell, the fragrance of many flowers which were growing. Through my heart, through in me they were growing. Through the soil they were growing. The roots going down under, going down and down through me. And I felt that friendship with my friends, like plants and flowers. And I could feel even the fragrance. I felt the deep friendship, a strong friendship with my friends, the plants and the flowers. And I could even feel the sweet fragrance. Yes. See, he says that I have become dead when I am separated from my, friends and relatives, plants, flowers, and even my Mother Earth. The potter has drawn out a living breath of me, has taken out the life from me. I have become dead. I was a living organism when I was with Mother Earth, with the plants growing in me, and with the flowers flowering and giving me fragrance. See, I have been taken out from that place and I have become dead, just like a goblet, just a goblet I have become. Yes, living breath is taken by the potter. He has taken out, you see, the living breath from me and given me a form which is death of me. He has given me a form, is a shape of a goblet. It is death for me. I am a dead creature now, no life. You see, no friendship, no family. I had so many friends, family members, plants, flowers, trees, so many were there. Now I have no one. I am alone. Isolated, separated. I am a dead creature. I am no friends, no family. I am separated from my mother. As I said in the beginning, see, as a child he is cut and separated from his mother. Okay, death of me, it is death for me. According to the goblet, it is nothing but death for him. My past unshapely natural state was best. Yes, how does he feel? My past, underline that, very important, unshapely, I can be changed in any shape, soil, you see, natural, that is my natural state. Yes, I belong to Mother Earth. You see, my natural state, I like it, that is best for me. What is best for it? My past unshapely natural state was the best. It was the best. It is the best, I think. With just one flower flaming through my breast. Yes, through my breast, one flower is flaming. See me, sir? It's not burning, shining. Yes, one flower shining, you see, through my breast, and the flower gives the fragrance, and I feel that fragrance, and I feel the company of the plants and flowers, etc. and etc. Part of the Mother Earth I was, I had been once upon a time. I am separated, cut away from that Mother Earth and made a pot or a tumbler or a goblet. I am a dead creature now with no life, silent, completely silent. Death, it is death for me. It is as same as death for me. Okay, now? So he does not like the present form. He wanted to be part of a Mother Earth. There were many friends for him. Family was there. Above all, Mother Earth. You see, he is separated from. So the goblin does not like his present form. He is made a slave by the, porter, a slave, and he is a dead creature with no life in him. He is cut away and separated from his natural state. So natural state is best for him. What is best for him? My past unshapely natural state was best. According to the earthen goblet, his past unshapely natural state was best for him, and he likes it so much. That is the story of the Earthen Goblet by Harinath Chattopadhyaya. I hope it is clear to you. If any doubt remaining, please make your comments. I will answer them, even the question answers. If you cannot find the answer, tell me. I will answer it for you. Thank you for watching. Meet you with another video. Goodbye.